Hello everyone, my name is Gökçe. Today I'm going to present my poster about core shell magnetic nanoparticles that are specifically designed for anti-tumor drug delivery. Let me zoom the poster a little bit. Here there is an illustration of the particles' final structure. In this study, we used several different kinds of biopolymers in order to assess their interaction with the particle itself and the final product properties. Let me go on to the methods. In here, we used iron oxide particles and we coated them with hydroxyethyl cellulose, nanocrystalline cellulose, and polyvinyl prodylon and kappa carrageenan. These polymers have different kind of properties, and we wanted to see their influence on the final product itself. We use colloidal characterization to determine the final product's properties. Later on, we used in vitro cytotoxicity assays to assess their anti-tumor activity. After coating the particles with several different concentrations of each polymer, we have chosen the best concentration to plot the flow curves of each coatings. Here in the first two graphs on the left-hand side, we can see the difference between uncoated iron oxide nanoparticle and the coated iron oxide nanoparticle. Uncoated iron oxide nanoparticles show the shear thickening flow behavior, but when coated with polymers at 1 gram per liter concentration, the flow converted into a Newtonian flow. This was also seen in all the other polymers we used. Then we moved on to electrokinetical properties and size. Here we have four graphs, and each for one polymer. We have plotted the zeta potential versus polymer concentration graphs. And according to these graphs, all polymers except nanocrystalline cellulose covered the particle surfaces. Nanocrystalline cellulose seems to only partially cover the particle surface. Later, if we look at the DLS measurements, which gives us particle size, average particle size, we can see that, let me zoom further for you. We can see that particle sizes increase as it is coated with each polymer. The most increase was seen in kappa carrageenan, and the least was nanocrystalline cellulose. When we move on to the drug loading capacity of each core shell particle, loading efficiency can be seen here for each polymer coating. Here we can see that the highest amount was achieved with polyvinyl prodylon coatings, and the lowest was for kappa carrageenan coatings. Later, we performed toxicity assays for each particle and compared it to pure DOX. The effect of each treatment can be seen here. We can see that at higher concentrations, except kappa carrageenan, has similar toxicity to cancer cells as pure DOX. But as the concentration decreases, the gap between pure DOX and the coated particles increases, which indicates that if these particles are used, the higher concentrations are more suitable for drug delivery applications. The result was that even though each polymer was effective enough at high concentrations to kill cancer cells, hydroxyethyl cellulose coated particles were much more suitable for targeted delivery applications compared to other polymers. Hydroxyethyl cellulose completely covered the particle surfaces and loaded DOX successfully. That's it from me today. Thank you for listening and have a nice day. Goodbye.